What's up everybody, it's Usama here and you're watching Tech with Usama. It's time to compare the camera of the Galaxy A70 with the Galaxy A50. I have the Galaxy A70 with triple camera system at the back. It's got a 32MP main camera, 8MP ultrawide camera and a 5MP depth sensor. On the front, the A70 has a single 32MP camera. Galaxy A70's camera can shoot 4K videos and 1080p videos at 60fps. Its camera app is equipped with the features like Super Slow-Mo, Slow-Mo, Pro Mode, Live Focus and all other modes that you see in a good Samsung phone. On the other hand, I have the Galaxy A50 with 3 cameras at the back too. It's got a 25MP main camera, 8MP ultrawide camera and a 5MP depth sensor. A50 has a 25MP camera on the front. The A50 doesn't support 4K shooting or 1080p at 60fps. It doesn't have the super slow-mo either, however it still manages to take very good videos and pictures. This comparison takes all common modes into account. For example, we do not have 4K or 1080p 60fps on A50, so no comparison of that. I have shot images in all the possible environments. It is also important to keep in mind that these are the same images that you saw in my A70 vs S10 Plus video. I shoot same images with multiple phones to save a little bit of time, so do not get confused about that at all. In this comparison, you will be able to see the following test. I would also like to tell you that why I am calling this a real life camera comparison. I am not a professional photographer. All these pictures have been randomly shot in a park or in my house. I have taken them just as an average user would take in his daily life. Before we start, please subscribe to my channel and help me reach 10K subscribers. Without any further ado, let's start the camera comparison now. First of all, we have the slow-mo shots from both the phones, and both phones have done well here. These phones captured 720p slow-mo videos. The Galaxy A70 also offers super slow-mo and I have done a separate video on that. In this video, I am comparing the slow-mo modes only. And now you can take a look at the videos from the rear cameras of both the phones. The Galaxy A50 and A70 can shoot 1080p at 30fps videos. The Galaxy A70 can shoot 1080p at 60fps videos too. A70 has this edge that it can also shoot 4K videos, which I have added in the S10 Plus camera comparison. And now you can take a look at 1080p at 60fps video from the Samsung Galaxy A70. Here is a very neat time lapse from both the phones. I actually loved shooting this time lapse and both phones have an amazing result. You can take a look at the focus speed from both the phones. The result is somewhat similar. Both phones take a little bit of time to focus on an object. I'm happy that they at least focus. Previous phones of this level from Samsung did not have a very great focus speed, so it's really good to see it here. Let's move on to the videos from the front camera now, where you can also check the mic quality of these phones. Hey guys, this is a front camera video recording race between the Samsung Galaxy A70 and the Samsung Galaxy A50. I'm out in the bright sunshine so that you can see almost all the elements in the background and in the foreground as well. So you can also get an idea about the mic recording quality of both the phones. Let me know in the comment section down below which phone's video and voice recording quality do you like, and which phone is giving you a better image of my background. Hey guys, this is a front camera video recording race between the Samsung Galaxy A70 and the Samsung Galaxy A50. I'm out in the bright sunshine so that you can see almost all the elements in the background and in the foreground as well. So you can also get an idea about the mic recording quality of both the phones. Let me know in the comment section down below which phone's video and voice recording quality do you like, and which phone is giving you a better image of my background. It's time to take a look at the pictures now. I have a huge number of selfies first. This one is taken outside. A70's picture looks more natural. A50's picture has a pinkish tone. The beauty effect of the A50 is more intense here. A70 keeps the details intact. The live focus is set at 5 in this one. Look at my shirt and my face. It's more detailed on the Galaxy A70. A50's picture looks really great, but that's not real. It's up to you whether you want the pictures to look natural or processed to look better. Another selfie outdoor in the sunshine this time. This one's all about the details and they are perfect on the Galaxy A70. Here is the same picture in the live focus. Decide the winner for yourself and let me know which one you find better. Here is an indoor low light selfie. Definitely the Galaxy A50's shot is better here. The warm picture of the A50 is good to look at. A70's picture, I don't know why, it's too cool. The same picture with the live focus. Both phones have a good picture, but for the colors and temperature, I'll go with the A50. And here is a picture in the night without the flash and then the flash. Since the A50 offers a brighter display, it did take nice shots by throwing the light on my face. I think both phones have an equally good picture here. Colors on the A50 are a bit deep. The same picture with the live focus. A50's picture is warm and vibrant. Background is more blurred on the A50. A70's picture is a bit less saturated than the A50. I think I like both phones here. The A70's picture is very well balanced here. A50's picture is just extra warm. Colors and sharpness on the A70 is worth it. The same picture with live focus. A50 for the depth effect and A70 for the well-balanced colors. Let me know which one do you like for this particular picture. Scene optimizer is on both the phones. A50 is trying to light up the colors while the A70 is trying to keep them natural. Shadows on the A50 are a bit overdone. Once again, the A70 keeps it up here. I really don't like what the A50 is doing with the shadows. White color just looks great on the A70. The real color of this floor is on the A70. The A50 is just ruining this shot by making the pink floor look red. Once again, it is the A70 that has the real colors. A50 is changing the colors of almost everything in this picture. The Galaxy A70 for the win again. A50 is adding too much of contrast and brightness to the picture. I think this pink floor looks better on the A50, but it misses out on the details. A70's details are really good. For colors, it's A50. For details, it's A70. Let me know about your thoughts in the comments. I think I'll choose A50's picture here because of that light. The A70 is making it a bit dull. Green looks greener on the A50. It looks yellowish on the A70. Let me know which green do you prefer. The color of sky looks better through the Galaxy A70. It's nearly white on the Galaxy A50. Here is a trunk of a tree from both the phones. These pictures can give you a great idea about the details. There is a big difference in the details from both the phones. Surely you can decide the one you like for yourself. And here is a number of pictures that I shot in a park. In all these pictures, the Galaxy A50 was slightly warm, while the A70's pictures were a bit cool. I like the pictures on both the phones, but for the color tone, I would prefer the Galaxy A70. Depending on what color tone you like, you can decide the winner on your own. Don't forget to let me know which phone's pictures look more appealing to you. Take a look at the wide and ultra wide shots now. In some pictures the A70 was better and in some pictures the A50 was better. Once again, I like the color balance done by the Galaxy A70. Now here is a building from the ultra-wide camera, wide camera and the 4x zoom. The Galaxy A70 offers 8x zoom too, but the A50 has only 4x zoom, so in this comparison I have added 4x shots only. It's time to evaluate the dynamic range. In the first picture, the sky looks quite good on the Galaxy A70 side. It looks like the sky is a bit dusty on the A50 side. In the same ultra-wide shot, the sky now looks better on the Galaxy A50. The blue color with pure white clouds on the A50 makes it look beautiful. A70 has done a good job too, but it's all about the preferences. And God knows what's going on with the A50 here. The A70's shot is what I remember seeing in real that day. The processing on the A50 has completely changed this picture. Take a look at the indoor low-light shots now. When it comes to details, the A70 looks better in some pictures, especially when you are shooting an object. The A70 clearly aces it, but when it comes to color temperature, the A50 takes the lead in some pictures. For example, if you take a look at the white background, you will see that the colors on the A50 are more accurate and it has nice details too. To me, it looked like a balanced competition between these phones. Your choice depends on a lot of factors, like how a particular color looks in a picture. You can definitely analyze the colors in these pictures to reach a decision. Lastly, I have the shots taken out in the night. Your hand needs to be super steady for these shots. In the first shot, the A50 won as I had my hand more stable while taking this picture. In the remaining pictures, the A70 won. In the last one, it was the A50 once again. That's all with the samples. Let's take a look at the verdict now. See, if you consider the features, the A70 is the way to go. For example, it has a super slow-mo, it can take 4K videos, 1080p at 60fps and etc. But if the features are not an issue, then to be honest, the A50 does not take bad pictures at all. So if you don't want to spend those extra bucks, I would suggest picking up the Galaxy A50, but if you have no money problems at all, then there is no mid-ranger better than the Galaxy A70 at the moment. You have seen all the videos and pictures, so the choice is in your hands now. In the end, it drills down to your own preference. Your opinion on these pictures can differ from me, so feel free to drop it in the comment section down below. Thumbs up if you like this video, subscribe if you loved it. I will see you in the next one soon.